I suppose you can stay. Aren't you the brave lord?
I'll be putting a knife in your
mouth.
What have you done?
But I don't want the brave lord.
All right. Well, this is a first. I'm on camera, and I didn't realize I looked like such a freak. Well, I want to thank you guys for joining. This is the Gaming VUE. I'm OmegaNikon. When is Game of Thrones coming? I know it's sometime this year, probably in the summer, but why does it take so long? I guess it's worth it. Last year's wait was huge, but the season was amazing. In my opinion, probably the best season to date. So I'm going to check out this game. Telltale makes great games. The Walking Dead was awesome, emotional, the first one I'm talking about. I haven't played any other ones, unfortunately, but now I'm going to play the Game of Thrones one, and I have all episodes. I started this one, so I'm a little bit in, not too far. I just got to where my family is from, the Foresters. So I think the big choices that I made in the first part where I let the little kid die, the other squire that was with me, I let him die. But other than that, I don't think there was too much. So I haven't read the books. I'm only going off the show. But I think that Telltale created this family and this storyline separate from, well, the interlines with the books and stuff. So it's been interesting so far. I think they did a really good job creating this family.
Two White Hill soldiers and a Bolton. They killed my family. And for what? My sister, she was only 8 years old.
The chat is up, just in case you want chat. I have it over there, so I can see it. It just might take a second. I'll look every once in a while.
You have my condolences. Thank you, Maester.
Thank you, Maester.
The blade cut deep, but I should...
If I could put subs on for yous. For yous watching with no audio. Audio, video. Display subtitles. Did that save it? Yes, it did. Resume.
You'd be able to save your leg. Your justice was swift. Some will call it vengeance. No doubt the White Hills will claim it was murder. It was your family. I can't say I would have done any different than you.
I'd do it again if I had the chance.
If we don't respond with strength, they won't stop until they have everything. These maggots ought to help prevent infection.
Gee, great.
Hold the wound open for me, would you?
Pretty fatty in there. Make a good rib. Glad I don't live during those days.
These are dark days, I fear. To lose
the
milk
of the
puppy house and the eldest son through such a despicable act of treachery and betrayal. Greater houses than ours have fallen in times such as this. The late Lord Forrester was a good man. And poor Roderick. A serious man, but he would have made a good lord.
Well, what so the only thing now? That sucks with streaming a game like this, that's based off your responses to people, is that the broadcasting
unprepared to lead.
On Xbox shows up right where the choice needs to be made, the bottom choice, and I cannot see what it says. So I will never be selecting the bottom one.
I understand from your uncle that Lord Forrester saved your life.
He did.
Rather odd that he chose to save you, his squire, and not his son Roderick.
Want to give you guys? Well, I'll wait till they're done talking.
Couldn't handle himself. He was as good with a sword as any man I've seen. It's unfortunate the Citadel doesn't train maesters in the art of warcraft.
Roderick had already fallen. There was nothing we could do.
I selected the bottom one. I'd imagine Lord Forrester
would sacrifice himself
odds.
To save anyone from his house, high or low.
Lady Forrester will be here any moment now. I'd like you to walk for me first, to see if you can put any weight on that leg. Go on. Don't stop now. It's better to let the blood circulate.
Let the blood circulate. So, if you guys aren't familiar with any Telltale games, you should check them out. Usually, they always give the first episode for free to give you a little, like, taste.
An ironwood shield.
The strongest wood in the known world.
But it's still wood.
You seem to...
The Ironwood Grove.
This lore is pretty cool, pretty interesting. So these are the Ironwood. This family, the Foresters, they harvest the Ironwood, which apparently is the strongest wood. I guess it's as strong as iron. Would make sense. But what I was saying about Telltale games, if you're unfamiliar with them, you know, it's usually mostly quick time events, but it's puzzles, it's exploration a little bit, not too in depth, and they're mainly story driven. So if you want a good story, and a story that's affected by, you know, how you play it, because it gives you options, it gives you choices to make, and those choices affect the game.
Asher. Exiled to Essos, unfortunately.
Oh, Essos. I thought you said Westeros last time.
Talia and Ethan. I suppose Lord Ethan now.
If you like that, check him out. Try him out.
Mira. Still I think in you King's can... Landing, I suppose.
I think Although, you can still...
I wonder if they'll bring her home.
Download probably the first episode of probably every one of them they've made. For free.
Lady Forrester.
The only one I've played all the way through is The Walking Dead. The first Walking Dead one. And man, by the end of that one, I was crying like a baby.
Son. Lord Forrester, it was an honor to squire for him.
An honor, I said.
Gregor the Good.
Gregor.
Roderick. He was our best warrior by far.
And I stabbed him in the back.
I may be mistaken. You do seem able to put weight on it.
No, how can you see me? Because I'm a spy. I'm a spy, I say. Who texted me? These landscapers are driving me nuts. Oh, I can't wait for season... What are we on? Season 7 of Game of Thrones? My maggot bucket. Yummy. Touch.
Rather Touch. Cute little creatures, aren't they?
I guess. Yeah. If I'm correct, so season... So maybe... No, season 7.
Keep moving. I need to see you.
Kinky. Man, season 6 was awesome. If I got my numbers right, if I don't have my number right,
you do seem forgive
me or correct me in the chat.
I believe your leg will be fine. Only time will tell, but. Lady Forrester.
Welcome home, Garrett. We're all relieved to know you survived.
Thank you, my lady.
Talia asked to see you.
Garrett, I heard what happened. Is it true? Your family...
Your family's dead too, what are you talking about?
so sorry.
Mato. Off to bed now. Hurry on. Garrett was just telling me how valiantly Lord Forrester fought to the end, even when all was lost. I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
He was a hero, my lady. The bravest man on the battlefield by far.
Yet he was unable to save his own son.
Jeez. You were with Roderick, no?
Just throw him under the bus.
I'm sure it was chaos and confusion. But if you can remember anything...
I'm sorry, my lady. Nothing could be done to save him.
He was House Forrester's best.
He was the best, damn it.
This has been so incredibly difficult for us, especially the children. But I was told... you were the last to see my husband alive.
Yes, my lady.
I know it may be difficult to remember, but if I may ask, was there anything he said?
Any last words before he passed?
He said he loved you.
That's very kind of you to say.
I kept my secret.
You have the Forrester sword?
I do.
Ethan should have it, now that he is Lord.
Lord Forrester asked me to return it to the house. He said this is where it belongs. With his family.
Thank you, Garrett.
Of course, my lady.
It demands a response. It's too dangerous, especially now. Now is the time to prove our strength.
I'll be sure it's given to Ethan.
Better.
Duncan, this was our land. They were our people. Your family. I share your outrage, Sir Roiland. I do. But now is not the time to provoke the White Hills. Not with Ramsay Snow coming to see us bend the knee.
The hell with Ramsay Snow, the bastard.
Garrett, you understand what this means. You killed a Bolton, and Ramsay Snow will want his retribution.
We're the ones that should be demanding retribution. This happened on Forrester land.
They killed my family.
And they'll pay for what they've done. That much, I promise.
How?
But now is not the time for vengeance.
It's not now. When?
When? We have to be smart. Ramsay Snow will be here within the week.
And what would you have us do? Nothing.
I would have us use our heads while they're still attached to our shoulders.
Garrett has lost as much as anyone else within these walls.
Oh, let
maybe
me tell
you
this
can
guy.
Talk some That'd sense into your uncle.
Garrett's suffered enough already. You ask too much of the boy.
He deserves to be heard.
My uncle's right. We need to be smart.
Smart. Eddard Stark was smart.
He sounds like the guy in Castle Black that hated Jon Snow.
Ultimately,
hated Jon Snow's guts.
It will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
Lord Snow.
He can barely hold a sword. He knows nothing of how to lead men.
He is the lord of this house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and swear fealty. But now, this. But I'll accuse you of murder, and us of protecting you.
The boy was just defending himself.
I'm not faulting him for what he did.
I'd have done the same, as any man would.
It wasn't murder. It was justice.
Not in their eyes. It's just
care whose eyes,
Ramsay
I'll cut them all out.
Need to put us to the torch and kill us all.
I'd like to see them try.
I'm afraid it's a risk we cannot take, which is why you cannot stay.
Cannot stay? Duncan.
I can't see the bottom one. It's driving me crazy.
Where would I go?
The one place beyond the reach of even House Bolton.
You're sending him to the wall. The boy's done nothing wrong.
Not in the eyes of the Boltons. I'm afraid it's the only solution. Especially now, when the house is so vulnerable.
Uncle, you can't send me to the wall. I'm not a criminal.
There'd be nothing we could do to protect you. To stay would bring destruction upon us all. I know that's not
true.
What you want. I know it's difficult to understand. But you must think of the house.
I'll do what's asked of me.
I know it doesn't seem
fair.
Because
I'm an honorable man.
It is what's best.
Which means I'm going to die, because this is Game of Thrones.
That settles it, then.
Thank you guys for joining us.
And I'll see you have plenty of food. But we haven't much time.
I was talking earlier about the anticipation of Season 7. I think it's Season 7. because season 6 was amazing. My favorite season to date. What's your favorite season? Let me know in the chat. I am looking at it. It's over there.
Word up to me. I'd gladly drive a sword through Lord Whitehill's heart if given a chance. I would. And God's willing, someday I will. But for now, I have House Forrester to consider first. I know you're not a criminal, but Lord Forrester would be proud that you're putting the interests of the house ahead of your own.
I told
him. Many of Lord Forrester's best men have volunteered for the war. His own great uncle was a ranger with the Night's Watch.
You're the only family I have left.
In my heart, I know I'll see you again.
How many times has that been said?
To tell you.
What?
It's important. Lord Forrester asked me to give you a message. He said, the North Grove can never be lost.
Sorry, you caught me by surprise. It's not often discussed, if ever.
He said, tell only you.
For good reason. Most don't even know it exists. They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools, and it's better kept that way. I assume you kept your word.
I did.
You haven't told anyone else, have you? This is important, Garrett.
Of course not. I told no one.
Well done. Lord Forrester was right to put his trust in you. From this day forward,
right, son.
This will be our secret.
I'm honorable.
I may need your help, but I can't say anything
more.
Which
is what's gonna get me killed.
The North Grove may very well be vital to the future of this house.
Understood.
But don't breathe a word of it to anyone at the wall. Become a ranger if you can. It will help. Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Remember,
this is a pretty cool family. I've never read the book, so I don't know if this is even
your actions at
a real family.
Reflect the honor and dignity of the house.
I'll serve with honor.
Honor.
I know
get my
know.
Head chopped off. I've never read the books. I don't know if this is a real family from the books that's just not mentioned in the show, or if Telltale just did an amazing job and created this whole family from the north that's loyal to the Starks. If so, it's pretty cool. They even show where they are located on the map. Which, they're west, a little southwest of where the actual wall is. So that's pretty cool. Oh, I forget. Sometimes I'm so into the conversations that I forget you actually have to do stuff in this game.
Be safe.
Come with me, honey. Hop on the back. Alright, fine. Stay. Jerk. Guys, for joining us, this is the Gaming View. I'm OmegaNikon, and I'm fiending for some Game of Thrones, so I decided to check this game out, Telltale. Every game they've made that I've played has been awesome,
Ethan!
So why not? These trees are ridiculous.
Ethan!
This creepoid. Ugh, skeevy.
I couldn't find him. Could you?
You'd like to engage in some chat.
He hides too.
My favorite season so far
smart,
of Game of Thrones was the last
himself.
Season 6.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game.
I win!
Congratulations, your lordship.
Time to be a douche.
Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game.
Ryan.
I don't like it.
He was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
I'm right here.
Punk.
And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asha. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and...
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Ryan,
she's very positive outlook you have there, son.
I promise you.
Ryan.
I don't want Garrett to die either. Maester Ortengren said he got sent to the wall. I'll miss Garrett. He was nice.
Garrett is strong. He can take care of himself.
No one will tell me what Garrett did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you.
I don't see how they do.
I know you'll protect
Ramsay.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
Jerk.
He calls you a milksop.
Sir Roiland forgets himself.
I don't care what he says. I can protect you.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know. But I know it's not good.
Milk sap.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword. Like a man.
Oh, really?
He taught Roderick and Asher, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
Give me my sword, I'll fight that kid.
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asher. We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
We had so much fun. But then, then everything changed. Roderick became so serious, the lord in training, and he never smiled anymore. And Asher just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are. I know a lord has many responsibilities.
I promise, I won't change.
Good.
Okay, he's not that much of a douche.
I'd rather have a brother than a lord.
I'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
Just as long as he doesn't try to marry her.
You can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once.
As many as you'd like, yes.
Really?
Of course. Why not?
I defy expectation. Oh no, Ryan will remember that. He's gonna ask me for sweets. On your feet. Later. Alright, let's see Ramsay. I'm gonna be a jerk to him. Hopefully, I wonder if they got the same people that do
the
voice.
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced, and certainly unexpected. He's come demanding justice.
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your All decision. Right. You are the Lord.
If I were Lord, I would command Ethan to stay with his family.
Fine. If that's what's required of me.
Very well, then.
Better remember that. I run this mess. Hack me off some of this wood. Flee! This fan's RPMs are just out of this world. Swords at the ready.
Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
The business with Garrett. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrett is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction. Out there, you were decisive.
That's gonna be easy.
Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
What should I say to him?
Tell him and his men to leave.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is.
Here comes the first big decision of my lordship.
And the backing of House Bolton.
Who do I side with?
Only cowards and dead men roll over.
Nice hair. Oh, it's a little chunky.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house. My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself.
Oh, now you're gonna be a jerk.
I've been waiting for this day all my life.
I may be young, but I'm not so easily fooled. You're trying to rile me, but it won't work.
Young? You are that boy. Too young to know when you're in over your head.
Really?
And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur. No courtesies. I should have expected as much.
Fetch Lord Whitehill some bread and salt.
Ah, I shouldn't have done that.
It was an oversight, Lord Whitehill. I promise it won't happen again.
Not likely. You foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the staff are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the North now.
Roos Bolton is the Warden of the North.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for 5 fucking centuries, you cunt.
Lord Ethan.
That's enough, Lord Whitehill.
I'm not finished. Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
This creepoid. Who's that douche?
Your man, the squire. We were minding our own business, keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said, when your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that?
And us for no reason.
For no reason.
That's not how it happened.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men, and a pig farmer at that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name, and you are the lord of this house.
Your men attacked and drew first blood. They murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. The soldiers worth 100 of their type. Where's the
typist
coward who killed my men? I know he's here. What have you done with him?
He was sent to the wall.
Who the fuck sent him to the wall? Answer me. Who's the one who did it?
You heard me. He was sent to the wall. It's done.
What? That was my justice to deliver, boy. And you denied me of it.
I'm not leaving dirt until I have my justice.
Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton. What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Oh, snap.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all.
But he just said he would have killed him if he had the chance.
It's not over.
It's over when my son says it is.
I've heard enough, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you,
the name is tight, the area is tight. Ironwrath. Iron from wood.
That
iron from ice. Sorry.
Maybe Lord iron of this ice. House. But Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. That the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
You're a craven, Lord Whitehill.
I don't know what craven is. Hopefully it's derogatory. Hopefully. Oh, you look at that stare. He's so into me.
I was wrong about your son, my lady. He stood up to him like a true lord.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee. Prepare a raven. We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once.
Wow, what's she gonna do?
King's Landing!
Your sister can help us. Although just a handmaiden, she has Margaery Tyrell's favor. And Lady Margaery's betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay. If it's presented to her as it should be.
Wonder if she gets fried in that, explosion? Oh, let's take a look! Oh, I can't wait for season 7. If it's season 7.
Yonkish coin. Asher sent me this coin to remember him. What a strange place, Essos.
Essos. A brooch.
It was very kind of Lady Marjorie to give this to me. It once belonged to Lady Elena.
Lady Elena. I think that's the old lady. Read. Look at. Now I will read it. Just pick it up and read it.
Father. Much excitement here in King's Landing for the coming wedding. Lady Marjorie has proven to be quite popular throughout the city. I do wish you and Mother could come, although I know it would be impossible under the circumstances. I miss all of you, and I look forward to the day you can.
I just want to go home. Carved wood.
Ethan made
my homeland. What else have we got in the shack? Dusty old tome. Spell tome.
Wonders made by man. By Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick.
Did you read it? Huh?
I hope to see them all someday.
Oh, you don't even know they're dead. Spoiler alert. Oh, the window.
King's Landing.
What a dump.
I wonder if it's sunny at Ironwrath today.
Probably not, because there's tons of trees there. Another letter.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally, especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
Thank you guys for joining us. This is the Gaming View. I am OmegaNikon. If you go ahead and hit that follow button, that'd be great. We'd appreciate it so much. You can also check us out on YouTube, where we got a ton of videos, probably too many. Hey man, I didn't open.
Sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, it's fine. Come in.
Dirty bum. Unless you work for, Varys. I'm gonna get stabbed up in this mess. What's he taking in there?
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but you alright? If you don't mind my asking, you seem rather upset.
I'm fine, thank you.
Of course, m'lady.
That's right. Who he works for.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady.
And you stink. You're supposed to take the poop out of the bucket.
Lady Marjorie?
And put it in that bucket.
I may be wrong, but it seems like you do.
It's widely known that I work for Lady Marjorie.
I've seen you with her before. You seem like good friends. I saw Lady Marjorie just this morning, outside the Royal Sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Cersei?
Shame.
They appear to be having some sort of disagreement.
Shame.
I couldn't hear much, but...
You were eavesdropping?
No, not at all.
I was dropping the leaves.
I heard them arguing about House Forrester and...
House Forrester?
I thought you'd like to know. Forgive me if I was mistaken. I hope you're not in any kind of trouble.
I'm not.
Most people don't tend to notice
nothing.
Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see and hear all sorts of things when people don't even know you're there. Good night, m'lady.
Gaga. Her?
Lady Marjorie, you're early.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk.
Sounds like her.
Come,
There's something we must discuss.
I wonder if it's in their Game of Thrones contracts they gotta do video games. If so, that'd be awesome. What's up, bitches?
From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining.
I need your help, my lady.
Of course, and I will help you in any way I can. But there's another matter we must attend to first.
Joffrey's a cunt.
You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford.
Yeah, Joffrey was still alive during
Cersei
this time.
Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept.
Because this is right after the Red Wedding.
She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor.
Of course she did. Show me.
She was
her in
very
the face.
Pleased with herself. Her face was full of mirth as she said it.
What does she intend to do?
She intends to make you miserable. Knowing that will make me miserable as well. She demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort. For what, I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her. I wouldn't ask this
Great.
If it were not important. I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
I'll do as you ask, my lady.
I knew I could trust you. Humor her.
That's right.
Tell her what she wants.
I'm one loyal lady. Open the door, men.
See if the Queen Regent is ready to receive us.
Yeah, get your ass. What you looking at, homie?
You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
Okay.
Good luck.
Good luck. Good luck. She went to the taken school of short sentences. What's up, homie? Hey,
you can do this.
My boy. Well. It's pretty cool. You're walking a lot faster than I am.
Ah, Lady Marjorie. Aren't you looking lovely this evening?
It is, him too.
Lord
Sweet.
Tyrion.
That's awesome.
Your grace?
Good job. Telltale's awesome.
With your permission. Allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Your Grace.
I am honored, Your Grace.
Yet not honored enough to kneel, I see.
I knew
House
it.
Forrester
see
is
it.
A northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Damn
Perhaps
right.
You should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
Joffrey is the one true king, Your Grace.
And yet, for centuries the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark, a house of traitors.
They were the wardens of the North. We all served at the pleasure of the king.
Clever girl.
Clever girl. Where's the raptor?
Perhaps
Get him!
Clever for her own good.
The girl did name Joffrey as the one true king.
Is your house willing to swear
oh,
fealty
I hope her
to your
is
new
as satisfying.
Lord, Roose Bolton?
Because Ramsay's death wasn't as satisfying.
He is the Warden of the North, Your Grace.
He is. And I the Queen Regent and Tyrion the Master of Coin.
The girl has a remarkable talent for answering questions while in fact saying nothing at all.
I knew he'd like that.
Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Yes, Your Grace. It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
Yes, Your Grace. I would do anything.
I see.
Okay.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
I'm sure she regrets it.
Perhaps. Perhaps not.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
This is tense.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing.
Too tense
define.
For this early in the morning.
This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within
can't
their
wait
hearts?
Until she dies.
If you are a girl from the north here in service to Lady Margaery, one can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure
Let
she would-
Let the girl answer the question.
I would be true to the king, Your Grace.
Well said. I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
My sense is this girl will say almost anything to get what she wants. Which is not very encouraging.
Shut up. Kill her right now. Kill her!
I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Change the future.
Of course, Your Grace.
That looks like a predator in the back. What's up, imp?
I'll walk you out. This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion. That's very kind of you to say.
That certainly took courage. To so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Margaery was humiliated, although Cersei seemed quite pleased. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters. The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard, not her.
You can help my family.
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Margaery might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house. Are you willing to risk that?
It's a risk I'm willing to take, Lord Tyrion. Please.
You are a brave girl, aren't you?
Yes.
I'll consider it. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. Three beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
I hope we meet again.
Nothing would make Cersei happier. Until then, be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
He's the man. Peter Dink. Ledge. Hide it.
Mira, I was worried. How was it?
Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing.
I'd rather not discuss it, if you don't mind.
Of course not. It must have been horrible. But at least it's over now. Lady Marjorie has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back. Here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Ah, Sir Jaime, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah!
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper.
As freaky as that guy was.
I'm told he has a paramour.
He is quite handsome.
And quite passionate. From what I've heard. Perhaps Lady Marjorie could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands.
No.
Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like.
Depends on the king.
Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen?
Hell no.
He does have a certain look about him.
No.
I'd be willing to marry, but not Joffrey.
Well, I would marry him.
Shouldn't have said that.
Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden.
Yeah, okay.
Let's see. Who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match.
He could sit on her shoulders. And then they could be Master Blaster. That'd be awesome.
Well?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful. The Queen was pleased by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over.
Me too.
King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes.
Interesting art style in this game.
There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once you know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
People are not always so easy to please. If you showed Cersei your true heart, she would stab it with a fork.
You learn very quickly.
I know.
Your words
I'm a genius.
Cersei are brave, but I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family.
Damn right. Well,
I
I'm
do
here.
Appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important. I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets
I hope so.
Between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her.
That hurt. Peace.
I prefer to speak with you alone.
Sorry, chick. Nothing personal. It's just because you got all googly-eyed about a seating chart.
Go on. Ask.
Please, Ramsay Snow is on his way to Ironwrath to see my brother bend the knee.
Ramsay? Roose Bolton's bastard.
I fear my family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. But if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown.
That is no small request, especially now.
Poor Favor.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire? Joffrey will not look favorably on such a request.
Please, Lady Marjorie, I beg of you. I fear for my family's safety.
I don't know, Mira. If Cersei were to find out...
You're the only one who can help me. You have power over him, Lady Marjorie, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
Thank you, chick. What chapter? Wolf's Wood. King's Road. Crap. Stupid horse. I didn't go out there with any swords.
Seven elves.
Flames. I knew it.
Let's play a little game, shall we? Did you know my ancestors wore the skins of their enemies as a coat? Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy, what with all that bloody noise.
Like a drowning cat. I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, the naked man holds few secrets, but the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father was the Warden of the North.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
My lord?
Shh! Listen. There.
Run!
Hear that? I know I heard something.
I should have. For some reason, though, I think.
Never mind. We've wasted enough time already.
When in doubt, hold your breath. Check to see if you cut that guy's wang off. Need something to eat. This guy's junk. Oh, I do have bandages. Maybe I can bandage his wang back on. Ugh, this guy's gross looking. His skin. Ooh.
Bloody hell.
I don't recognize the guy, so. Blech.
Lord Ethan, as I was saying, you are young, and there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership.
but
beating a dead horse,
300
buddy.
Generations of Forester lords stand behind you. Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good.
Gregor.
He was fair and wise, and courageous in battle.
I want to be like that, like my father.
Your father was well regarded by nearly everyone. It took years, if not decades, to earn.
I understand.
These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forester Lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others, the Lord Sentinel. Forester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore.
A Lord Sentinel. This dude. Hey, man.
We need his judgment.
Time to pass it down, bruh.
I've done nothing wrong. I was only trying to survive.
But you stole. Chop his hands off.
Lord Ethan. Maester.
Who is this man?
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed!
That's not helping your case.
We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
Why did you do it?
Because I've no wish to die. Yes, my lord, I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks truth.
I've a family to feed. And not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here.
Where's our pay?
Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone. Mercy, go.
Citing a riot, are you?
I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter.
We are in this together.
You say that, but it won't be you who's starving come winter.
You'll address him as Lord. Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers, three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it is.
Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their lord will not permit it.
He's a thief. We can send him to the war.
Leave the man alone. Show him mercy, my lord. He stole from us.
Don't be looking at me like that.
Give us justice.
I will decide.
And send him to the war.
Take his fingers.
He's a thief.
If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord.
How are you innocent?
Please, my lord. My family depends on me.
I sentence you to the wall, where you will join the Night's Watch.
No, please, my lord! My family, without me, they'll die!
Tough knickers. I'm almost done.
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due. Not just yourself, of course.
Maester, what do you think?
Me?
Yes. Did I do what's right?
The wall seems like a fitting place for a thief. I only hope he doesn't find Garrett there and take his anger out on the poor squire. You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side. Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance. Possessing wisdom.
Who do you think I should choose?
There are two capable men for the role. No. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here, the bracer of the Sentinel, the badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen Sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house.
I am.
Your Sentinel will wear this for all to see.
I understand. I'll do it now.
Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
Aye. Dang train. Creepoid, I know you're looking. Hey, you looking at me too? Get to hacking up that pig, bro. I'm on some bacon. Tower.
Our provisions are rather low, my lord. I made the count again, just to be sure.
How bad is it? How long could we hold the house?
We couldn't withstand a siege, my lord. If the Boltons or the White Hills cut us off and wait us out, we'd only last a fortnight. But there are steps we can take. In the past, we've demanded food from the small folk to replenish our stores. We can do it again, if you'd like. We've done it before, in desperate times.
No, there must be something else we can do.
Cut up some horses.
I hope we find it soon. We won't have much room to maneuver if we don't have the option of holding fast. I can speak to the huntsmen and trappers. Perhaps they can do more. My lord.
You're all worthless and weak.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
I haven't decided yet.
Well, you must soon, my lord. This is not a matter to be taken lightly.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
He didn't even give me advice. Cut this horse up. Malcolm.
Ethan. Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
Oh, the heck you are.
I saw what you did today. It's not an easy thing to do, showing mercy to a man who admits his guilt. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow.
But where are you going?
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him, to help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, that I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted. I will hold, of course, until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
She's my mother. Of course I'll be gentle.
I know you will. You're good-hearted, my lord. That is your true strength.
But my mother's
fears are not the only ones I face. Just why my heart will soon be on a stake.
My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job. He'd be a fine choice.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
Ethan, I need to talk to you.
Give me a second. Yo, what are you touching?
Mother told me Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all
smoking.
Else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man. You promised me you wouldn't change And I believed you.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrod being sent to the wall without my knowledge.
I know. And that wasn't your fault.
But I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What? Ethan, please.
I wish Father were here.
We all do, but Father is gone. You are the Lord of this house, which is why you must be strong. You're just as capable as Asher or Roderick ever were. I know it.
I guarantee you, when I ask her, she's going to tell me to get the other guy, because she's kind-hearted.
Good advice.
Kind-hearted. Well, I didn't ask her, so.
Sword up! Swing left! Parry!
Parry!
Wrong! I didn't know dogs could hold swords.
A word?
Of course, my lord.
Are you loyal?
I have decisions to make, and I wanted your advice. I need to name a sentinel.
Ah, you do. And it's good you came to me. I know this house, and everyone here knows me. They know I can hold the reins, or wield the sword in equal measure. I'm the man you need. And might I remind you, it was Duncan Tuttle who sent Garrod to the wall. He undermined your authority and made you look weak to the White Hills. I would never do that to you. And if you pardon me saying so.
Duncan Tuttle is a good man.
Aye, a fine man. Wise even. But he has no business being sentinel. He likes to talk. But now's the time for action.
Who should I choose? So, let me know. In the chat, you have, like, a couple of seconds.
Tonight, at the small council meeting.
Very good. I trust your judgment, my lord.
I'm leaning towards Roiland. Just because of what my uncle said. Because it looks like Ramsay's on his way. I need somebody that'll tell him to shut up. So that we can all get flayed together. Won't that be fun? Won't that be fun? What's up, little homie? Ryan.
Careful. Keep at it and you won't have much left. Something to pick your teeth with.
No, Ethan. Look at this. All good swords have a name. I call mine Two Brothers. I carve this to give me strength.
Aww.
And this, so I remember. I mean, I could never forget. But, you know, don't you?
You honor Roderick with this. He was a strong one.
He was. Yeah.
His mouth's not open. Or someday is he playing?
I'll have a real one. But not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
Yeah, what the
heck? You'll have a good sword.
Where is my sword?
I'm sure of it.
I watched you today.
Trust that maester.
I saw what you did to that man. Was he our enemy? A bad man? Everyone keeps talking about them.
Rules mean nothing if we don't enforce them. It doesn't matter if he's good or bad. You can't steal. That's a rule.
Well, I say he was bad. Bad men killed Father and Roderick. They need someone to hurt them back. Even worse. I want a
real... Being raised right here.
No one's afraid of wood. I'll find the men who took Roderick someday, and I'll make sure I have a real sword when I do.
Good boy. It is a tight-looking shield. Contemplate my decision. I need to choose a sentinel, which is basically an advisor, and I'm either going to choose Roiland, who is like the master of arms, a warrior, hothead dude. That's him yelling at these guys. Or Duncan, which is... I don't know where. I don't know where he went. Where are you going, homie? Duncan is, like, easygoing, smart, kind-hearted.
Slash and parry. Slash and parry. Again.
He might be beneficial in, like, calming angry situations. This guy is probably going to be a hothead and be like, "Rawr, kill them all." And Ramsay Bolton's on his way. So, I don't know what to do. Talk to this homie. Get on him. Ask him if he...
Maester?
Yes, Lord Ethan. I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
What is it you're doing over here?
Admiring the ironwood, my lord. I studied it at the Citadel. The wood may be black, but I see gold. An entire forest of gold.
What do you mean?
It is our greatest asset, my lord. Why not give some of our ironwood to House Bolton and have them leave us be? We could ransom ourselves. You can hardly put a price on your own life, or the lives of those you love.
Ransom or a robbery? We may pay him now, but what's to stop him from coming back again?
Lord Ethan, the dangers of today outweigh the fears of tomorrow.
I disagree with that statement.
My lord, are you now ready to name your sentinel?
Yes.
Yes, Maester. I'm ready.
Donk.
Very well. I will convene the small council at once.
I'm gonna go with Duncan. Even though I don't have 100% feeling, I'm leaning towards Roiland, but I think that he's gonna get me into more trouble than I should be in. Especially when good old Ramsay Wang Cutter comes over. Boy! This is a tough decision, damn it.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan
has reached his decision. Mom.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you. Duncan, Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
Let him be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel. But I have made my decision.
I don't know. Whoa. Oh, I thought I was gonna choose. Tell me, mother. I'm gonna give.
Sir Roiland de Gore, you will be my sentinel.
Gods be praised. You've done well, Lord Ethan. You won't regret this.
I hope
not. A poor choice, my lord. Forgive me for saying so, but it's true.
Now, Sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
My scouts say he's a day's ride away. We've no time to waste. He'll arrive before any of our allies could be here.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
We can handle Ramsay Snow. He doesn't scare me.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword. That's bloody suicide. You gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls. Quiet, Tuttle. You're not the Sentinel. I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This is the small council, is it not?
Let Duncan speak. I'd like to hear what he has to say. Duncan?
I'm sorry, Lord Ethan. You have chosen your sentinel. You should hear from him first.
Well, then stop interrupting him.
The Bolton Sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand.
It's kind of true.
Every man who can hold a spear or crossbow on the wall and make the bastard fill his boots with piss.
He would see it for the empty gesture that it is and have us flayed. We must take a measured approach, my lord.
Gentlemen, please.
Okay.
Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf, but we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help us.
We all must agree on the plan. We cannot leave until we have a consensus.
Ugh.
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah, the wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough! Although Sir Roiland may object, I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow. I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
Don't be pissed.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival. Invite him into this hall, and meet him face to face, lord to lord.
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd. You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze upon Ironwrath. And when he enters, he'll know it's only because you allowed it.
Lord Ethan?
I will meet him at the gate.
Very good, my lord. I shall prepare the men.
Men? We hardly have any. It's a foolish plan.
Shut up.
That's enough from you, Tuttle. Lord Ethan has spoken. Obey his command.
I've faithfully served this house for far too long to sit here and listen to this. Forgive me, my lord, but you are far too young to be the lord of this house.
Hey, man.
You're likely to get us all killed.
Sit down at once.
You just got done telling me how loyal you're going to be. Now you betrayed me.
Apologies, my son. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow at the gate, and we will not offer our ironwood.
Hell no, we won't.
No matter what, I will stand beside you, my lord, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
My lord, you have named your sentinel, but you still seem conflicted. And no matter what, you can't be indecisive. Not if you want to help this house. Forgive me.
There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family. Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back.
He's a skilled fighter. What's more, he has the will to fight, a hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister, and we need all the help we can get.
Why would you bring him back after you exiled him?
He exiled himself. He has no desire to rule. Asher is volatile, but that is his strength too.
This guy sounds tight.
Do you remember the miller's boy? How he tormented you? I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious, but you were in danger and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities, but...
Asher is dangerous and unpredictable. His presence could help or hurt.
Having another sword at your side always helps, especially now.
Okay. Let's bring my homie home, my brother. Let's bring my bro home. Bro
that. I'm trying to do what's best for this family, what this family needs. Ethan. Let me send Malcolm to Essos.
Fine.
Very
Malcolm
well.
Will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
Just don't die.
Thank you, Ethan. I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a forester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Let's hope so. Send that raven. It should let you fly the ravens to different places on the map. As a minigame. Alright, pick it up. Snagged. Time to play the Game of Thrones. Shoot, I'm about to forge this mess. She's a kleptomaniac.
Marjorie?
Oh.
Lady Marjorie is still with the king. I thought you might want to know. Thank you. I thought we were friends, Mira. When you dismissed me the other day, I won't say it didn't hurt my feelings.
Oh, yeah, get over it.
We've known each other for years.
We are friends, Sarah. Truly.
Friends trust one another. They don't hold secrets. Now Lady Marjorie thinks you don't trust me. And she values your opinion very much.
Sarah, I...
No help.
My lady, I'll leave you to talk.
Drag the heck out of here, son.
How is King Joffrey, my lady?
The king was not inclined to offer help for your family. I'll need this mended.
Gods.
Peter?
He said I was too easily swayed. And he reminded me that I am not yet his wife. I allayed his fear. For now. But it will be a long time before I can ask him for anything again. Nothing I said could cheer him.
What can I do to make this better, my lady?
There's nothing you can do, Mira.
Please don't hold it against me. Ramsay Snow is on his way to Ironwrath.
About to forge that letter so lovely.
This is simply not how things are done, Mira. Not in King's Landing.
I'm sorry, my lady.
Soon I will
blood
be queen.
Blood on your chest there.
And maybe then I'll be in a better position to help you. But for now... Now... We must both be cautious.
I must send a raven. I have to warn my family. If you'll excuse me, my lady.
If he gives me the option, I am going to forge the hell out of that letter.
My lady.
No, thanks for spying on me.
Begging your pardon, my lady. I hope I didn't frighten you.
How long have you been waiting there?
Not long. I was just passing by when I saw you emerge from Lady Marjorie's room. I hope you saw. I was right before. About Lady Marjorie and Queen Cersei. I just want you to know, I can help you if you'd like. And your family, if you're willing to trust me. I hear all sorts of things. Things that could be useful for you.
How can you help me? My problems can't be solved by what you might overhear.
Which is why you must trust me, m'lady. You need allies. Hopefully I've proven I'll
trust
be useful
some dust rat.
I'm sorry. I really must go.
Please don't despair. I know people who...
Jet!
be willing to help you.
The mountain? No. What you looking at, homie? It's a walking.
Where the bloody hell is Duncan? Now fuck him if he's hungry. I'm without King's Landing. I know you'd hoped Mira could help us, but I'm confident we've enough strength of our own.
Let's hope
so. Your men are ready to act if needed.
Sir Roiland, I trust you'll keep a level head.
Of course, my lord. But the bastard of Bolton can't be trusted to do the same.
No. Bolton men approaching, my lord!
Get this over with. Ramsay, how many sausage shanks have you cut this morning? Chip bastard.
Something wrong with your gait? Well, aren't you the little lord? No wonder you can't open the gate. Shall we help you? Now let me in. This is a lovely pile of timber, isn't it?
You may enter.
Oh, may we? How gracious of the lord.
I hate this guy.
And you said he wasn't a proper lord.
A token for the new Warden of the North.
Let me guess. Forrester Iron.
Carved by our most skilled craftsman.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much.
Your father will appreciate it, I hope. Our ironwood is highly sought after.
My father is not so easily impressed. Not bad. Lord Whitehill, can your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn.
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently.
Nope. Not even close, bruh.
Quite the army you have, Lord Forrester. Very impressive.
Alright, here we go. Just trying to piss this D-bag off.
Look at that. More foresters.
Lord Ramsay.
Come out or I can see you.
Force him to focus on the business at hand.
Lord Ramsay. I understand you've come here for assurance of our fealty.
Fuck fealty. We came here for justice.
We'll get to your justice. First, let's see you bend the knee to my father. Lord Bolton, Warden of the North. Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now. was it?
No. You are the Warden.
I don't care about your loyalty. The Crown, however, wants what you've got. Whatever you've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships, shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the King. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you? That wouldn't reflect well on me.
We will double our efforts for your father, my lord.
That's a good little lord.
You can't trust her, Forrester. They murdered our men.
It was a Forrester squire who did it. One Whitehill soldier dead. One Bolton.
He was within his right. They killed his family.
His right? He killed a loyal soldier in my father's army. You had me stand out in the wind and muck so you could show off your pathetic little army. That sort of insolence from one of our loyal bannermen will not do. So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone. The Whitehills will be taking control of your Ironwood from this day forward.
What?
What? The Ironwood? But...
The Whitehills are nothing more than up-jump thieves!
You can't do that!
Why not? You know something the Whitehills don't? We are talking about trees. You grow them, you cut them down.
We have loyal craftsmen who make the finest weapons. The Whitehills have no such craftsmen. Do you want ironwood for the next 5 years, or the next 50 generations?
The little lord does have a point.
Right.
We'll try this. Lord Whitehill will take half of your ironwood, and we'll see who fares better.
But my lord...
Half of something is better than the nothing you had before. To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls.
At Ironwrath, that we cannot abide. Ethan.
They'll help maintain the king's peace.
This will cause more trouble, not less.
Not for me. You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
Griff will lead the garrison.
The Seven Hells he will.
Lads, do make this visit worthwhile.
Please, Sir Roiland, don't.
Look at this little forester. You're not frightened, are you?
Lord Ramsay, please.
And you? Are you Lord Ethan's older sister?
I'm his twin, my lord.
Oh, twins. Like the Queen and her brother. Well, hopefully not just like the Queen and her brother. I never had a sister. Always wanted one.
We have more to discuss, Lord Snow.
I have an idea. You'll come with me. You can be my highborn ward.
Lord Ramsay, that's enough.
Do you like hunting?
Let her go.
She's quite pretty, your sister. We'd get along well.
You've gone too far, Lord Ramsay. I demand you let her go.
I suppose you can stay. Aren't you the brave lord?
I'll be put a knife in your
mouth.
What have you done?
But I don't want the brave lord. Far too much trouble.
Ethan!
My lord!
No!
Even though you did bend the knee. I think we've come to an understanding.
Ethan!
I certainly feel better about all this.
My.
However, the foresters need to keep their end of the bargain.
Stop!
Brian!
Take the boy as your ward.
No!
Kill him if they give you any trouble.
Brian!
Lovely meeting all of you. We'll have to do it again sometime.
Somebody help him!
Fetch the maester quickly!
You brought this on yourself.
Mama!
Stop!
Don't let him take me!
You will not take
Stop
him!
Stop now, please!
Ryan,
please!
No!
No!
Ryan!
Do something! Why I always,
Ethan?
Like, expect that's not going to happen in Game of Thrones. What the heck? Good God, man. Man. Now it's begun. Yeah. You think? I did not expect that. That is so crazy.
Ethan sacrificed himself for us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
This house needs a leader.
Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you did it without flinching.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us.
Not her.
Those who hold House Forrester above all other loyalties. Those who will not stop until Ethan is avenged. Until Ryan is home again, our house will not fall. We will be ready.
Nothing comes without a cost, my lady. Are you prepared for what might happen?
And this is what I like at the end of Telltale Games, they tell you what percentage. So, me and 34.2% left Bowen behind. That was the other squire that was with you in the beginning, right when the red wedding, the betrayal happened. Some soldiers were coming, and you can see his neck there, he's dead. You and 62.4% swore loyalty to the king, okay? You and 35.4% sent Eric to the wall. You and 30.9% picked Royland as Sentinel, so most people picked Duncan. Yeah. I probably had the same outcome. You and 49.9% met Ramsay at the gate. Dang, man, that was shocking. And I should have, like, I've watched every episode of Game of Thrones multiple times. Like, I don't know why that still surprised me that one of the main characters you play as in the first episode of this game freaking gets killed right at the end by Ramsay Bolton, who yet again, even though he's dead in the show, still manages to piss you off. Oh my goodness. Well, that was episode one, guys. I'm gonna cut it down. We'll put it to our YouTube channel. Just check us out, subscribe to us. We're gonna hold a little giveaway when we hit 50 subscribers. We're just starting out. We got tons of videos though. So go ahead and check us out there, The Gaming VUE. Once we get 50, we'll be giving away 3 $10 gift cards to the platform of your choice if you're selected randomly. You get to let us know whether on Steam, Xbox Live, or PlayStation Network, we're going to send you a $10 gift card for being a subscriber. Follow us here on Twitch. We're trying to grow a little bit on Twitch here. Get to the ever-so-coveted partner status. And we're going to start trying to make our videos better and everything like that. Oh, let me look at the camera now that we're doing a camera here. But that was episode one. I decided to play this because it's been a while since season 6 of Game of Thrones. I can't wait till season 7, which is going to be later this year. Hopefully it was just as good as last season. Last season, in my opinion, was the best. And so I decided to check out this Telltale series. I just finished episode 1. There, I believe, is 6 episodes, 6 or 7 chapters in each. Maybe about 2 hours each of gameplay. So thank you for watching. I am OmegaNikon. This is The Gaming VUE. We'll see you later.